Life coaching turns cutthroat thanks to a kid's basketball game. When you need a referee, who do you call to settle the score? Well, Dear Snarky, of course. Back with another edition of Dear Snarky in the Suburbs is our friend Sherry Kuehl. Welcome back. We appreciate you being here today. As per tradition, I have not read this letter, but it was teased to me by our executive producer saying this one is a doozy, but I'm like, they're all pretty much doozies.
This is when, like, I was reading, I'm like, la, 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 what?
Yeah. Okay, all I'm right. Ready for it.
Let's get to it. Dear Snarky, I need your help to get someone banned from their job. I've been seeing a life coach for several months. I really like this woman, and I found her advice helpful.
Okay.
Our relationship after a couple of sessions was really less life coaching and more like two girlfriends talking over coffee, except I was paying her 50 bucks an hour. A couple of days ago, I was at my son's middle school basketball game, and he got called for a foul.
As they do.
When this happened, a woman stood up on the bleachers and shouted at me, "Maybe you need to add teaching your son to play basketball to your personal goal list." The woman screaming at me was my life coach. It turns out her son was on the opposing team, and he was the kid who my son got called for fouling. I didn't notice that she was at the game because she was above me in the bleachers. When I looked up and saw that she was the person yelling at me, I almost cried. It was so embarrassing. I can't believe this happened and that this woman was so unprofessional. I think other people need to be warned about her. I would think that she could lose her accreditation over this. What steps do you suggest I take? Signed, disappointed, and embarrassed.
Is there an accreditation system for a life coach?
We're going to get into that.
Okay. Because that's my initial thing. But oh my goodness, how horrifying. That's incredible.
Can you imagine someone, you're like, what? And then you look up to see who's screaming at you. You're like, oh my gosh.
And it's her.
Life coach.
I'm not sure if those would have been the words that I would have used. But, you know, I can't say those on TV. This is crazy. Are you sure this is real?
Somebody's like, who? I mean, that's just too random.
No, this is definitely something that would be written about on Facebook. And then there would have been drama on both sides, and
exactly.
There would have been like a weeks long thread of responses from the peanut
gallery.
That's
why when I see stuff like that on Facebook, I just keep on scrolling.
That's right. All right, I want to know what your advice is
here
because this is going to get in deep here.
Okay. Dear Disappointed, I hate to be the bearer of more disappointing news because I know you feel like your trust has been 100% violated, but I don't think there's much you can do to this loser of a life coach. The profession is currently an unregulated industry.
There we go.
You're not required of any certification or any education to be a life coach. In fact, I could decide to be a life coach right now. Kind of liking that idea.
Yeah.
But enough about me. Here's what you can do, and I call it basic level complaining. Go ahead and post a bad Google Yelp review, and you can even start a vigorous word of mouth campaign that this life coach is less than awesome. The most important thing you need to do is move on. If writing this life coach a "you're horrible" letter helps you do this, then by all means, start typing. And here's another fun fact from a non-life coach. Stop marinating in what happened at the basketball game. Wallowing in this is taking time away from getting your life in order and or living more fully, which is what I'm guessing you were seeing a life coach about. I also don't think this should stop you from having a life coach. Mm-hmm. You did say you found it helpful, and I know some people who are life coaches and they have excellent reputations. I would suggest doing more research and asking people who you respect for life coach recommendations if you decide to venture in this direction again. Until then, there's always me. Dear Snarky.
That's right, and I have the chip reader on my phone ready to take your credit card now by calling this 900 number today. So.
I don't think I'd be a great life coach.
I think you'd have very
it'd be the tough love.
Advice.
Get your stuff together. Come on.
Get it together. Turn your life around and get going.
Exactly.
We always appreciate you being here. And you know what? The more we think about it, I think that's way too specific to be made up. I'm sure that happens somewhere.
It's just like,
and it's got to be something.
Who would
that
ever hear of that happening?
And then of course she's going to be nice to you. You're paying her 50 bucks an hour.
Yeah.
You're going to be girlfriends by the end of it, right?
Yeah, you just got coffee, talk. Yeah, I'll do that for 50 bucks an hour. I'll do it for 25.
Cut it in half. We'll still be there. She's Dear Snarky in the Suburbs, bringing you 21st century advice with that attitude. Read the books, follow the blog. You can message Sherry on Facebook. We have a link to everything Snarky on the website. Thanks again.
Thanks.